From the times of the ancient Greek, Aristotle was making the example of currency as something purely conventional. We accept currency because we trust one another. I'm Andrea Baronchelli, Associate Professor in Mathematics at City University of London. I've been very interested in the self-organization of decentralized socio-technical systems. So, how we coordinate and develop our behavior in the absence of a centralized authority. This has led me to investigate different questions: misinformation online and polarization, and the other one is the cryptocurrency blockchain ecosystem. What happens with misinformation online, addressing explicitly global emergencies. So we studied the vaccine discourse, we looked at the dynamics of dark web marketplaces customers, and what we found is that you have vaccines, but you also have proof of vaccinations. Because if you are a no-vaxxer, you don't want the vaccine, you want a certificate that says that you have been vaccinated. And if that market shuts down very rapidly, like within 48 hours, users redirect themselves to another market where the experience is recreated immediately. So that showed that there is this ecosystem of markets and you need to consider all of them. Decoding our behavior in these circumstances can provide inputs both to the society and to industry. What I want to do with my research is help understand this very human quality of developing complex behavior by being together. So all things that you would never be able to decode by studying a single human for even infinite time, and that happens when you put a lot of humans together. The popularity of NFT surprised me. They started invading a little bit the gaming industry, actually more than a little bit, but they were outside of the public, and then in 2021 they exploded. It was probably also due to the fact that the pandemic made us realize the importance of the online world, and they offer a clear answer to ownership in an online environment. In our research, so we did this first paper mapping the NFT revolution. There was this big sale of people selling this NFT at Christie's for £69 million. And what we found is that the market is very concentrated. A small fraction of traders was doing most of the trades, to the point that 10% of the traders do 90% of the transactions. I studied classics in high school and then went into physics. But this love with the human element remained. And so now trying to study and understand human nature with methods borrowed also massively from physics is the best of both worlds from my point of view.